I believe space travel represents the best of humanity. Our ability to develop complex tools, to work together and accomplish what no one could do on their own, and to survive in environments that are completely hostile to us. But what does it take to survive in space? I'm not talking about the obvious stuff like a pressurized, oxygenated atmosphere, protection from ultraviolet rays, and comfortable temperatures. I want to talk to you about what it takes to survive psychologically in space. Scientists have spent decades understanding space psychology, and I want to share with you three of their most important findings. Number one, build an effective team. Astronauts work in suffocatingly small spaces, long days, and rely on each other to complete their missions. Small conflicts between crews can quickly escalate into serious life-threatening problems. That sounds like the plot to pretty much every alien movie. This is why teamwork is the number one priority for mission control. When it comes to assembling a crew, the most important criteria NASA psychologists look at is the health of a candidate, how well they sleep, and how they work with others. NASA creates mixed-gendered crews because they perform better than single-gendered crews. With a multinational crew, space programs make sure everyone gets the same training, regardless of where they're from. Training includes classes, simulations, and virtual reality. NASA focuses on helping a crew learn how to communicate with each other, make decisions together, support one another, and deal with unexpected situations. Along the way, crews develop a common language and begin trusting each other. In space, crews work to maintain their teamwork by eating together at a table and celebrating each other's customs and holidays. Number two, create Earth-like conditions. Our biology developed to survive on Earth, and the same is true of our psychology. This is why space creates so many problems for our internal clock, the suprachiasmatic nucleus, or SCN for short. The SCN regulates circadian rhythms, which wake us up in the morning and make us sleepy at night. Because the SCN is located right next to the optic nerve, sunlight has a big impact on our sleeping patterns. More sunlight and you feel more alert. More darkness and you feel more tired. The problem with space is astronauts don't get the same exposure to light that they're used to on Earth. The International Space Station orbits the Earth every 90 minutes. The SCN isn't built for a 90-minute orbit, it's used to a 24-hour cycle. This gives many astronauts a feeling of constant jet lag. Combine that with the loud sounds of machinery on the space station, and it's no wonder so many astronauts suffer from insomnia, chronic drowsiness, and need sleep medication. The solution is creating as many Earth-like conditions as possible. NASA recently replaced the International Space Station's lights with a new LED system that creates colors similar to what we get on Earth. It's kind of like how we use light boxes to treat seasonal depression, the smart lights you can buy for your home, and the mood lighting found in most modern airplanes. Number three, develop rapid brain and behavioral feedback. NASA's mental health team meets with astronauts in space and their families on Earth on a regular basis. While astronauts can reach out for help anytime, it's too impractical for ground mental health teams to check in on a daily basis. The astronauts' schedules are just too full. This is a problem because the people astronauts rely on for support, their friends and family, aren't there with them in space. Sure, the crew will check in on each other, but what if they're all feeling sleep deprived or irritable? Or what if an astronaut is experiencing a problem with another crew member? This is why NASA is developing remote brain and behavioral feedback systems. The goal is for the ground crews to intervene with problems in space before they compromise mission goals. This is the kind of stuff that would have really helped Matt Damon in Interstellar. On future missions, a badge will measure an astronaut's heart rate, speech, and their distance relative to other crew members. Ground teams will be alerted if the crew is experiencing problems or if someone is isolating themselves. NASA psychologists have also developed tests that remotely measure an astronaut's mood and stress using behavior, saliva, and facial recognition. All of this information will one day be integrated with artificial intelligence that will provide therapy to astronauts and help them get back on track. Understanding space psychology doesn't just make you a better astronaut, it can make your life easier here on Earth. There's so much more we can do to build better teams, to bring the right mix of people together and help productively deal with conflict. We can create environments that work with our psychology instead of against it by changing the colors of our monitors, screens, and outdoor lights according to the hours of the day. Creating behavioral monitoring systems on our schools, campuses, and workplaces could identify people who are in need of help at the first sign of trouble. I've barely scratched the surface of space psychology. For much more, check out NASA's free ebook, The Psychology of Space Exploration. What questions do you have about space psychology? Let me know in the comments below. We'll be right back.